Hi everyone. Today I'm going to teach you how to use the IntelliPath tool as part of the AutoTURN Pro software. AutoTURN has helped engineers around the globe over the past 25 years to perform this task with trusted results throughout the transportation industry. The IntelliPath tool automatically performs swept path analysis for complex scenarios such as various routes for site circulation. In this scenario, we have the BC Children's and Women's Hospital along Oak Street in Vancouver. This is a superimposed version in AutoCAD and it's taking it off of the Google Maps view right here. The intent is to make sure the proposed site design and road network can accommodate the vehicles that will likely be navigating this path. So the plan is to have the vehicle traveling northbound along Oak Street, take a right turn, travel into the drop-off area within this parking lot, and then go up north along the perimeter of the hospital right here. It's going to be requiring some tight turns, so we're going to be using a larger vehicle to push the software to the limits. First, I'm going to make sure the settings match the drawing skill. Navigating to the settings allows a variety of categories to be adjusted. Because this drawing is scaled to meters, I'm going to select the units for AutoTURN to be in meters. So the last thing I want to do before opening the IntelliPath tool is to freeze the hatch layers. In this case, I'm going to go to Layers Properties and just select to freeze it right here. As a result, this will make it so the landmark can be easily selectable. Next, back to the AutoTURN tab, I'm going to open the IntelliPath tool. And first I'm going to be prompted with a new route analysis area. In this case, I'm going to name it my area. This tool will help us generate turning movements for different vehicles based on the space available. So once in the tool, we can start by defining the area where we want to define the routes and vehicle movements. We are going to do that by first clicking the button to the far left, which is Pick Analysis Area. This will allow us to define a boundary around all of the relevant spots of the simulation. Roughly, I am just clicking around the parking lot, drop-off area, and then going up to the northern perimeter of the hospital. Back down to Oak Street right here. Once the boundary looks okay, I'm going to right click to finalize. And the next step will be to click the middle button, which is to pick exclusion lines. In this case, I want it to stay in the right lane on Oak Street. So I'm going to select the dotted line as well as the shoulder right here. And onto the parking lot drop-off area, I'm just going to set my boundary again. Adding exclusion zones and exclusion lines then allows the user to select existing landmark to be in effect. Basically, in other words, this will define the roadway limits, which are restricted from vehicle traffic, and lane lines to mark dedicated lanes. Finally, moving up to the northern perimeter of the hospital. I'm going to right click again. Now once that is done, I am going to click Add Route. Within the exclusion lines I made, I'm going to left click the start point. And we can see with the purple shading, that represents the trace path that I'm making. As I drag along here, I want to stay within the exclusion lines that I made. And as mentioned earlier, it is going to navigate through this parking lot and up the perimeter here. And I'm going to do the final left click right here. So I'm going to right click outside to finalize. And now it has prompted me to make fine tuning adjustments to the exclusion lines that I originally made. So I'm going to start off right here. You can see that due to the nature of the exclusion lines, it's also shading way out here. Obviously we don't want that, so I'm going to left click here, my first point, then select right here for the other end. And I'm going to hold down control to allow a nice smooth arc. There, I will left click to finalize that. And yeah, just all along here, it's the same iterative process. I'm going to select there as my first point, and then right here, left click again. Here, I want it to be a straight trajectory, so I'll set a straight line like that. I also want the vehicle to ignore the parking stalls, so I'm going to click there like so. Also right here. Here I'm going to have to hold down control again to make a nice smooth turn like that. And there we go. I can fine tune it a little bit more, but I think this is good enough. So I'm going to right click again to go back to the interface. And now it is prompting me to add a movement. So I'm going to click that. And so now I am prompted the generate movement interface. The first thing I can do is select the vehicle of interest. Because this is located in Vancouver, British Columbia, I'm going to select an ambulance under a North American region. So in this case, I'm going to select the MedTech AD-170. I'll select OK. And I also have the option to specify the speed constantly throughout the IntelliPath path, or I can have the IntelliPath determine the maximum achievable speed. And for a conflicts check, I'm going to have the front and rear tires envelope. I can also select the vehicle body if I want to. I'm going to select OK. And now it's going to prompt me to select my starting point. I'm going to align it to the road edge right there and have it traveling north. Like that. And now it is prompting me to select my endpoint. So I'll left click again right there. And I'll just let it load. There we go. So now the ambulance has successfully navigated this path without any conflicts. We can see where it starts. The envelope for its front to rear tires are outlined. It goes along here, through the parking lot, and up the perimeter. Now, if I want to, I can make the shaded route disappear. I can also do that to the simulated path of the vehicle. I'll toggle that back on. So I'm gonna click close. Now, after I close the interface, it just shows the simulated vehicle path as well as the drawing and its original elements. Pretty interesting. Thank you for watching our how-to video on using the IntelliPath tool. In this video, we had an ambulance automatically perform a swept path analysis using the tool. We hope this video has been helpful and informative and you have learned something new today. If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlist with more videos on similar topics. These videos go into more depth and provide more insights and detailed analysis on vehicle simulations using AutoTURN. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay updated on our latest videos. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. Thank you again for watching and we'll see you in our next video.